Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
We'll now come to order. At this time, I want to ask Commissioner Manning if he will give the invocation.
Let us pray. Dear Father, we again are grateful for the opportunity to meet, do the work of this county. Please help us to understand the issues, to listen to our citizens as we move forward. Bless us at this special time of year. Help us remember to reflect, make time for family and friends, remember the season. We ask all this in your name. Amen.
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 And at this time, I'll turn the program over to the county manager.
Thank you, Madam Chair. At this time, in front of you is a copy of our minutes from November 21st. Is there a motion to approve the minutes as presented?
So moved.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, minutes are approved. Next on our agenda is the election of chair and vice chair. We will begin with the chair. For the Board of Commissioners, is there a nomination for chairman for the Alamance County Board of Commissioners?
Point of order before we do that. Can you have two nominations for the same office at the same before any vote's taken?
Yes. I mean, you would vote on each nominee one at a time.
Okay, but there can be two nominations.
There can be two
before
nominations.
Any vote's taken.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just for clarification.
Am I correct, Mark? Yes.
Are.
Okay, thank you.
I would like to nominate Tom Manning for chairman.
Second.
Any further nominations for chair? Make a motion is there a motion that we close nominations?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Now we'll vote on the motion. The motion is to appoint Tom Manning as chair of the Board of Commissioners. Is there a motion?
Is there a motion or a vote?
Or a vote. I'm sorry. Is there a vote? I'm sorry. Excuse me. That's the reason why I sit over here. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Is there a nomination for vice chair?
I'd like to make a nomination for Bill Ashley to continue as our vice chair.
Second.
There's a motion and second. Any other nominations for vice chair? All those in favor of Bill Ashley as our vice chairman, please signify.
Aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? We have our chair and vice chair.
Congratulations. You got it. You got to take over.
You want to just sit there for the night?
No. Thank goodness.
Put him to work right off the bat. You can keep your coat, too.
That'll be fine.
Don't take the electric coat.
Oh, no. Oh.
Yeah, I thought that was a coaster. I'm not getting your stuff. Well, here then.
Bob, how you doing? Good.
Well, thank you. Thank you, fellow commissioners. I appreciate your support. I look forward to serving in this position. I look forward to continuing to earn your trust and support as we move forward. And I think that's the key of this. We do continue to work as a board. I think we work effectively as a group. I'm excited that will continue in the future. And I'd particularly like to thank Chairwoman Massey for her service, certainly during my 12 months, but also during the previous time before I got on the board as chair as well. And I appreciate everything you've done.
Thank you.
We now have the before public comments. It appears that we're going to have approval of bonds for certain public officials. Mr. Honeycutt, is that correct?
Yes, sir. You should have a list of the bonds in front of you, the public official bonds, and they are for Gerald York, Amy Weaver, Hugh Webster, Terry Johnson. Just need a motion to have those approved.
Craig, are these, I'm sorry.
So moved.
Is there a second?
I second it.
Now, we'll have discussion. Is this a renewal or is this an increase from where they are now?
It's a renewal.
So it's just strictly renewal?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any discussion or questions for Mr. Honeycutt about the approval of security bonds?
I've asked this about every year on this, and for the life of me, I don't remember the technical answers I keep getting, but are these maximum bonds or are they too high, too low, or?
Too low, especially.
They're statutory recommended.
Those are recommended.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, good.
Thank you, Tim. Any other
right.
Any other questions? Not, we'll call question. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried. Now it's time for public comments. We have one request, Carl Buckland. Mr. Buckland, welcome to the podium.
Good evening. My name is Carl Buckland. I reside at 913 West Old Glencoe Road. I'm here tonight to publicly comment and petition the county commissioners to investigate and to make a citizen's inquiry into the following subject matter, the water and sewer tapping fees, the water and sewer policies of the city of Burlington. The city of Burlington has accepted community development block grants through the county. I've talked to Mr. Martin. I don't, by phone, I wouldn't recognize him. Is he here tonight?
He is back on the map.
And I've talked to Mr. Sutton about this in the past. And the more I look into this, the more unfair it seems. The city of Burlington started their this new policy after the state legislature passed legislation that almost banned forced annexation. They got mad at the state legislature, and so they're going to take it out on the citizens of Alamance County. It's not right. They charge fees based, where community development block grants were given. They charge double for these taps. They charge double for the sewer, for the usage of the water and sewer. They also allege that they're charging these fees equivalent to water assessment to be paid to Alamance County. This is where I want to inquire, make a citizen's inquiry. How much has the citizens of city of Burlington paid to Alamance County for water assessments? If the city of Burlington has not paid anything, which I think they haven't because they promised to pay me things, which they haven't, for lines that I've done, if they have not done this, this may constitute criminal action because it's illegal to collect funds for one purpose and not apply it to what you took it for. This is called a conversion. In my interpretation of law, it's a conversion of property.
Clyde, can you answer that? Can you tell us something?
I'd like to know more facts about
okay.
the grant. What are you talking about?
Well, I'd like to hand this up to be put into the record. This is a plat that was given to that came out of the city of Burlington's files.
They said they're giving money to the county. I'd like to know how much they've given.
It's a whole lot the city of Burlington does that the citizens would like to know something about.
Well, this is why I've petitioned you to investigate. I've also asked HUD to investigate. HUD is looking into this matter. I've been told that they are going to look into the matter. The HUD gives these grants to the poor communities to help the communities. And is it right? This is certainly not in the principles of the city grabbing these funds and
Thank you, Mr. Buckland.
That's
we have a 3-minute limit on our public
well,
comments.
Well, I have a petition before you, sir. The First Amendment does not limit the time limit on the First Amendment.
Well, this is the public comment time, and if you
I also said it was a petition also.
Carl, get with Clyde, and we'll hear what you have to say. Thank you. We now have a presentation from Dave Leonard on the insurance district change, I believe, from 5 miles to 6 miles in a certain part of the county. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you, commissioners, for the opportunity to come here tonight. I'm sorry, Dave.
I'm getting ahead in my first night. Are there any responses from the commissioners at this point? Thank you, Madam Chair.
Well, I think we need owe Mr. Buckley the courtesy to look into that and to follow up on that.
And give me some contact information, we'll get together in touch with him.
Thank you.
I'd like to ask one question. Are you in their ETJ zone?
I'm in their ETJ zone.
Right.
Yet they were going to double tap.
That, they doubled the charges on the water.
The city of Burlington would do to surprise me.
Even if they allow it, you've got to go before the city council to even get a tap. And then you've got to sign a petition to give away your constitutional rights to get water. The United Nations General Assembly said this is a human right, that citizens have access to clean water and sewer, but yet the city of Burlington sees fit to vote on human rights. That only happens in the third world country, I thought.
I'm glad you are agreeable to meet, Mr. Buckley.
I can meet with you tomorrow if you'd like, sir.
I would be agreeable.
Okay.
Tell me what time would be convenient. I'll be here.
After 2 would be fine. After 2 o'clock.
Dave, welcome. Sorry.
That's all right. I come for you before you tonight to ask permission to move forward with increasing the current fire department fire districts, which are now at what's considered an ISO 5-mile rated district, to push them out to what's considered their 6-mile ISO districts. This is the first step in this process. The state requires us to come before you asking your approval to do so. Once we get your approval, which can be recorded in the minutes from this meeting, once they are approved, we can move forward with collecting all the data that the Office of the State Fire Marshal's Office will be reviewing to make sure that there are no overlaps and that we are providing them with the proper documentation that each fire department can provide the proper fire coverage for these extended districts. So again, tonight, we're just here to ask your permission if we can move forward with this. It's going to be a fairly lengthy process. We hope to possibly get it done in about 6 to 9 months. In working through the Office of the State Fire Marshal's Office, we will be collecting data here through our GIS department for the maps and things to provide them. So it will take some time to get this information documented for the state and presented to them for their reviewing. Once they review this information, they will send it back to us, and we will then bring it before you for its final approval. What this will definitely help out is currently the current 5-mile rated districts, which all of our departments have, if you live outside of that insurance district, your homeowner's insurance and even your business insurance is set at a higher rate. So if we increase this from a 5-mile district to a 6-mile district, those that are in that 1-mile buffer will receive a reduction in their insurance rate. And that's kind of depending on what type of policies and things that they have, obviously. But all the fire chiefs in the districts are willing to push forward to make this happen, hopefully have that significant savings to our citizens as well as the businesses that are outside of this current 5-mile district. I'll entertain any questions you may have. Again, we're wanting to push this forward as quickly as we can. So I'll open it up to any questions you may have.
Do you think that would encourage any requests for fire tax increases?
No, sir. The fire tax rates and things is totally different from the insurance ratings from that standpoint, so it should not affect any of their fire tax ratings that they currently have.
Well, I mean, you may have answered it, but at budget time, you don't think they're going to say, because we've done this, that we're going to have to request another half a cent on the fire tax?
No, sir. Currently, our fire departments, to comply with this, to move forward to a 6-mile, we have to show that we're sending at least a minimum of a 1,000-gallon tanker to respond on automatic aid. Right. We're currently doing that now. So basically, we already have that in place. Now, what we are seeing some fire departments wanting to do is even if we push it to a 6-mile district, we're still going to have some citizens that will be beyond this 6-mile rated district. And in order to prevent that or to bring them into a lower insurance area, we're going to have to possibly build a new station in those areas to give them that 6-mile within that 6-mile or 5-mile buffer. So for whatever the fire department would need to do to put those
plans together. You know, we'll definitely be up to that individual fire department, their tax boards, as well as this board here too, as well, in building possibly new substations for their current stations. That could possibly happen, and we look to see that. Because again, we have some areas, even if we push this to the 6 mile, we'll be beyond that, and we want, again, to provide as much protection as we can for our citizens out there.
What's it going to do with the overlaps?
Basically, when we, with GIS, with our mapping capabilities that we have now, when we push all these out, they will touch each other. There will be no overlaps. That will be part of that review that the Office of the State Fire Marshal will come in and make sure that we are not overlapping anywhere in the insurance districts. So that's part of their review.
So we are now?
There is no overlaps right now. All of them are currently at 5. So anything beyond that 5 is considered.
Could be potential.
Could be potential for moving beyond. Yes, sir. We have a couple of departments that are bordered by municipalities. So we'll push them all the way up as close as we can to that municipal line.
I know just from talking to insurance people and stuff, this is considerable savings once it's put in place.
Yes, sir. There has been a push from the insurance companies statewide. We have noticed it here in Alamance County. We are fielding calls every day from citizens that their insurance ratings now have increased because we currently have a 5 mile district, and if they were at a 6 mile district, if we pushed it out to there, they would not see this large of an increase. But this is statewide, so Alamance County, along with other counties, will be pushing to move their districts, expand them to 6 miles.
Dave, what is the 9S classification?
If you were here a short while ago when Mr. Bradley came from DOI, Office of the State Fire Marshal, he explained that insurance ratings are basically from a 1 to a 10, 1 being the best rating, which typically a 1 through a 3 is very substantial for businesses and things for their insurance purposes. And 4 to about 7 or 8 in that area is what most of our rural fire departments are. A 9S means you are getting that coverage. You're not quite a 10. 10 would mean technically there's not enough coverage available for you or enough protection available for your coverage, I guess is the correct way to say that. So a 9S is not a 10. It's still getting you the necessary equipment needed, but yet it's not the true rating of that fire department in their respected 5 mile district.
Other questions for Dave?
Not a one.
Is there consensus by this board that we allow Dave to move forward in his quest?
I would say we would.
I'd say so.
And you need consensus as opposed to a formal vote?
Yes, sir.
At this
that
time.
Will be fine. Just the approval is what the state has informed me of.
Okay. Yeah.
Sounds like it's there.
Yes, sir. I appreciate it. I will keep you updated on it. Thank you.
Thanks, Dave. Now turn to the county manager reports. First on your report list is the mutual aid agreement, Craig.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. In working with the city of Burlington, Mebane, and also Graham, we started talking about how we can best jointly utilize our current building inspectors. Again, with job losses and our economy not needing as many inspectors, there's a chance for some overlap. So what we talked about was a mutual aid agreement, which would allow our inspectors to work with the municipalities and their inspectors to work with us. This is based off a 1995 agreement that was originally entered into by the county and the city of Burlington. Basically, what this would do would still everybody keep their own staff. However, if one group got busy or they needed some additional help, or if one municipality needed a level 3 inspector and they did not have a level 3 inspector, the county would step in and fill that void. And that may save the municipalities or even the county from having to hire on an additional inspector at this time. So we're trying to best utilize the existing inspectors across the county instead of trying to fill those short-term slots. And with your approval, the cities have all agreed upon as far as staff and concept, and they'll be taking this to their boards as well for approval.
I think it's a step in the right direction.
So appreciate Dave.
Right now, I think we've got too many inspectors for no more work than they're doing.
Right. And appreciate Bob Strobridge is here tonight, and I appreciate the work Bob's done trying to help us get to this point as well. Again, it's really just trying to utilize our existing resources to the best of most efficient way we can.
Other comments, questions for Craig or for Bob?
I do want to say there's one thing, and I talked to Eddie the other day about this, and there was some concern about communication to make sure that there was very good communication between the counties and the municipalities when that is being done, and we'll make sure that we have very good communication with our partners.
Thank you, Craig. Is there a motion?
Yeah. I'll make a motion that we move forward doing that.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve the mutual aid agreement that it was last, I think, signed in 1995. Any other discussion or questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you.
And just a couple of dates. Wanted to remind you of our joint leaders breakfast at ACC on December 7th. And also our joint meeting with ABSS the morning of the 13th.
Is it Tuesday or Monday? I should know.
Tuesday.
What's
today's date? The ACC breakfast is Wednesday, and the ABSS meeting is the following Tuesday.
Right.
All right, Tuesday.
Right.
All right, Tuesday morning.
Okay.
I can
remember the date. And that's all I have.
Thank you, Craig. Fellow commissioners, if you will review the consent agenda and review the items there, the appointments, and also information on the tax refunds, is there any item there that you wish to remove from the consent agenda? If not, is there a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
Thank you, Bill. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Tim. Any discussion on the consent agenda? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Very good. We have a closed session. I move that we now go into closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute 143-318-11, Part A, Section 3, to consult with our county attorney in order to preserve the attorney-client privilege between the county attorney and the Board of Commissioners regarding the case of Alamance County versus Crown Castle. And I move that we also go into closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute Section 143-318-11, Section A-6, to consider the qualifications and conditions of appointment of a public officer or employee. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Tim. He beat you. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, we'll go over here. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Appreciate it. Second.
Thank you, Bill, Eddie. The board. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Ms. Linda, any opposed? The board in closed session considered and voted to approve the settlement with Crown Castle in the case of Alamance County versus Crown Castle. County Attorney, Mr. Clyde Albright, will now report the terms of that settlement. We'd like to enter that settlement document into the minutes of this meeting. Clyde, welcome.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The county did reach a settlement with Crown Castle for the tower at the closed landfill site. Crown Castle has agreed to pay the county $35,000 in cash and to enter into a revenue share of 75% of all future revenues to the county and 25% to Crown Castle to manage the tower. Assuming that the tower brings in $31,000 a year over the next 4 years, and we believe that it will, the total revenue plus the $35,000 will exceed $128,000. And I'll enter the settlement agreement into the record. We will file a dismissal tomorrow with the federal court and dismiss the lawsuit. Thank you.
Thank you, Clyde.
Clyde, thank you for all that you've done on that. We know that,
that
you
some unfound
picked
money
it up, and you're the one that's behind it, and we appreciate your hard work doing it.
Thanks, sir.
We now can take final action in the form of a motion regarding our three-month appointment of Gerald York as an interim tax assessor. Gerald's contract with the county, his current contract, ends this Wednesday night, and the board met to review a proposed extension of that contract, which would result in a renewal until March 31st, 2012. Contract further provides that after March 31st, 2012, that Mr. York would return to the tax department in a capacity that is yet to be determined. And I would like to entertain a motion on that contract, interim contract renewal.
I'll make a motion that we accept it.
I'll second.
Thank you, Eddie. Bill, any other questions or discussion about Mr. York's interim contract? If not, we'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Very good. Thank you, Gerald. Thank you for the work you've done. That completes our report on closed session. It's now time for any closing commissioner comments. Do we have any?
What I'd like to say about Linda's situation as our chair, you did a job as chair that I could have never done. And not because I didn't want to, but I just wasn't able to do it. I mean, you have a love in your heart to represent this county. Not that I don't, but you were a great chair.
Thank you.
And for us to switch, I don't think it should be intended to be anything personal.
I understand.
You know that. You should know that.
I understand.
This is a partisan board, partisan office holders, and so forth and so on. And I think you deserve the time off, frankly.
She does. Yeah.
I just gave to Mr. Manning. If anybody wants to see, these were my committees plus two others from the state. And these were theirs. And Mr. Sutton has the least on here.
Well.
But thank you anyway. So I just gave this to you so you see the ones you got to take off.
Thank you. And thank you, Tim. That was very well said. I'll speak to that in just a minute.
Thank
but are there any other comments from other commissioners?
I'd like to say that I've been on this board 16 years, and I think Linda has been the best chairperson since I've been on this board. She treated everybody fair, and that's all that you can ask from a chairperson.
Thank you.
Thank you for all that you do.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bill.
And I'm going to have to give the same sentiments. And we came in at a tough time when Linda and I came on this board.
We did.
We had a lot to deal with, the tax revalves, and Linda did just a yeoman job with it. And
I want to tell y'all, too, that the previous tax administrator in her resigning letter said that she couldn't work under my leadership. And I said, that's the first thing she said right since I got here.
But thank you, Linda.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Well, and I just add to what I said at the beginning of this meeting. I appreciate your support, and watching you over the past year has certainly helped me understand what's going on here.
Yeah, what you got to do.
Yeah. Now, you've given me this report with these committees, and some of them under your name have dashes, and some of them have don't.
The ones that have
and I don't
dashes,
know which is which.
Well, the ones
so.
That have dashes, I'm going to keep.
No. Okay? Well, that's good. That's good. Them. That's good.
And the others, you need to appoint these gentlemen to them.
What we'll do on this matter, seriously, we'll get the committee list out to everybody. You can review it, and not just the ones that Linda's talking about, but any of them. And if
right,
there's one that you particularly want to be a part of,
yeah.
Wonderful, we'll get it. That would be effective at the first of 2012, so we've got a little time to do that. But, Tori, if we can get that list out to everybody and get the information back to Tori on which committee you would like to serve on, then we'll just go from there. But thank you for bringing that to me.
You're so welcome.
Any other announcements or comments? As Craig said, we'll see everybody Wednesday morning at ACC for the breakfast. And if there are no other comments, we stand adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.